The effect of lameness on animal welfare and animal performance is costly and wide-reaching. Whether you're a large-scale livestock operator or a family pet owner, the sight of an animal in pain is distressing and must be addressed. To shed new light on this important issue, Zinpro Corporation is proud to sponsor Experts Talk, the place where leading authorities on foot health and lameness prevention share their expertise. This episode of Experts Talk examines claw trimming in sows as a method to manage lameness. Our expert today is Dr. Robert Dove. Dr. Dove is an associate professor in the Department of Animal and Dairy Science, where he teaches multiple animal science classes and conducts research.
When we went to group housing, now we have sows that have to get up and walk every day. They have to go to the feeder. They have to go get water. They have to protect themselves from that dominant sow. They have to be able to move much easier, much better to maintain their productivity. Well, we know that lameness and feet and leg problems are one of the leading causes of culling in most of our commercial herds. Some of research indicates that maybe as many as half the gilts that we cull from a commercial herd are culled because they can't walk. One, I think we make the sows much easier to move. They're going to move a little quicker potentially, but just simply the ease in getting the sows to move from barn to barn, location to location, has to be a big plus for him because it makes his life easier. Secondly, from a management standpoint, we're decreasing the number of gilts we have to bring into the herd. Means we don't have to manage as many gilts, means we're getting more productivity out of the sows that we have. We decrease our culling rate. All of those things are things that a lot of our managers get paid for, so I think that would be an incentive as well. In our study, we were looking at a number of sows that had long claws, and we were looking at what effect trimming those claws had on their locomotion. And to do this, we set up a couple of high-speed cameras and we videoed them as they walked through a defined track so that we could very accurately measure things like how long a step they were taking, how long they were standing on 3 feet versus 2 feet within each step, how long they were moving the foot versus how long they were standing on the foot within each stride. And then we also captured some video from the rear that just simply allowed us to look at how she was walking, how she was tracking. We were able to show some significant changes in how she locomotion down the track after we trimmed her versus before we trimmed her. We could see changes almost within that hour in how she walked, and by 48 hours later there were significant changes in the way she moved. Her stride length was about the same, a little longer. Her stance time or how long she was standing on each foot tended to shorten down a little bit. How long she was swinging the feet were shortened down, so she was moving faster. Calculation is that she's probably moving another meter and a half a minute. So we're moving her down the hall that much quicker. But more importantly, you could just see by the way she was walking that she was much more comfortable. She seemed to be much happier moving, much easier to move, much easier to handle after we got her feet trimmed. I think you're going to have a chute of some kind to trim claws. You've got to get those feet up where you can get to them. The FeetFirst chute works very well for doing that. Whether the claws have got overgrown, whether we bruised one and it's misshapen, whatever, by trimming those up and bringing them back to the proper shape, we allow her to walk properly. We reduce stress on the joints and the hips and the shoulders. I believe that in a lot of herds, it's going to be a very useful management tool, and I think it's going to be one that would pay for itself given the number of gilts that we're going to save back, or the number of sows that we're going to save back and avoid having to replace gilts. I think from an animal welfare standpoint, it's going to become one of those things that we're going to have to start being responsible in doing.
For more information on the FeetFirst Swine Lameness Management Program, visit zinpro.com. Thank you for watching this episode of Experts Talk. Additional episodes are available at zinpro.com. Experts Talk, promoting foot health, preventing lameness.